buttons on the side of the elevator? What a country.
Here we are in Trafalgar Square. I'm sure I'm saying that wrong.
Kind of a good short video, wouldn't it?
Taking a piss here, that means just goofing around. It ain't that big. Elementary, my dear Watson. We need to solve the case of being too sober. Oh, I get it. Because it looks like an eye. Candy floss. Fuck. Everything. What a country.
Yeah. We got kids crying. Yeah, no. Pass.
The Westminster Bridge. See an old Big Benjamin. Cheerio.
Oh, here you go.
Ooh, what's going on? A left. And it'll do it 11 times now, right? Proper annoying.
Let's just walk down here and someone will instruct us, I assume.
All aboard.
We've left the pier. I am required by law to give you a very quick safety announcement. It's very important that you get people to wave on the bridges here in London. It is for your safety. Because if they're waving at us, they can't throw anything at us.
Okay, boo.
Now don't worry if some of them didn't wave. It just means they're from London and they're miserable. Is the world famous and very expensive Harvey Nichols restaurant, and in the middle, lots of luxury, unaffordable houses. Building with a thatched roof. This is a replica of William Shakespeare's Globe Playhouse Theatre. Home roof. This used to be the home of the offices of the Mayor of London, built especially for the Mayor. And then he decided he didn't like it and he's moved downriver. And proof that your vessel will not fit underneath that bridge at the state of tide at which you arrive, and they lift it free of charge. In the middle, you have the White Tower, the original part built by William the Conqueror.
You know what they don't have here in London? Situational awareness.
That's why.
People from out of town.
On holiday.
On holiday, yes.
So we looked up this place on Yelp. The travel agent suggested it highly. Really excited to try some of the local fare. KFC, baby. I don't know what that stands for, but I assume King's fuckery.
King's fried chowder.
King's fried chowder.
Sitting in the park, drinking a
food. I love it.
They got
40s. They got 40s here. Think they got OE? That's where it came from. Old English?
Yeah.
Wait, is this Peter Pan? That's the J.M. Barrie guy that we heard on our tour. If this is dodgy to you, you're no better than Mom.
Any place where people are drinking 40s alcohol
is dodgy.
40s, by their very nature, are dodgy. Well,
your son has participated in some dodgy behavior in his time, then. I'm documenting this in case something happens, because Dad keeps thinking we're walking into a dodgy part of town. That don't look too dodgy to me. This is Big Ben's trailer trash cousin. Middle Ben. Well, we're not gonna wait in line, but there it is. It's the in the line here
for the photos.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just here, please.
No, I want a
simply magical. And you're sure it's this one? Yeah. On our way to Piccadilly Circus. Frederick, Duke of York. We're loving what we're seeing, but can you explain this gap in your resume? There he is, the one hiding in the bushes.
2002, so actually 101 when she died. It's interesting, there's a lady who they say got through 70 units of alcohol a week, so maybe that's not such a bad thing, is it?
Guys are real guns, and just like those guns are real soldiers, he's not real policemen, obviously, and those guns...
Cross on the other side, please. If he stands in here, it won't be nice.
Now you can be in hand, but you in fact have been over 5 foot down before.
You still have to be like
4 foot
five.
Yeah.
Okay,
well, not in this regiment, but in other regiments. It is changing now. The horse guards, for example, they've been allowing females in for about 10 years.
Thank you.
They're the military band. So, yeah.
They played Dad's favorite song.
That's right.
Shut Up and Dance with Me.
That's right.
I Walk the Moon.
Too many people care about this.
Currently headed to grab lunch at a place that came highly recommended. It's called King's Fish and Chips, but here in London they just call it KFC. So we'll see what the hype's all about.
Is Lizzie home? busy Mongol.
Our first stay on the adventure on the Cotswold Trail, a small bed and breakfast in Chipping Camden. You put us?
Yeah, I can. What's today, 20?
Day one of our trek on the Cotswold Trail begins in Chipping Campden.
We're here at the Chipping Campden Marking Hall, built in 1627 as sort of a farmer's market back in the day. And it marks the beginning of the Cotswold Way. And from here, we'll walk 102 miles to Bath.
Please enjoy our adventures, accompanied by a tune that concerns our friends, the Hobbits. And we have just reached Dover's Hill, about 20 minutes into the hike, which is the second highest point of the Cotswold Cut, which is the highest point of the Cotswold. Mr. Frodo, this is it. If I take one more step.
Broadway Tower was built in 1799 by the 6th Earl of Coventry as a folly or useless outbuilding for his wife, Lady Coventry. It sits atop Broadway Hill, the second highest point along the Cotswold Way, and the Broadway Tower, built for Lady Coventry, is Great Britain's first she shed.
Almost 5 miles into day one on the Cotswold Way.
Hey, hey, the princess. Hey.
We're approaching the town of Broadway, a tiny town in the middle of our trek today. And we will take a left on High Street, getting off of the grass and mud of the fields here for a little bit as we continue on our 10-mile day one. Already fell.
We've been through the village of Broadway where we had a panini and a pint, and we're continuing towards Stanton, but still looming in the distance is the Broadway Tower, a folly built by the 6th Earl of Courtney to appease his wife. So that massive stone structure is England's first she shed. It's just this, it seems so, I don't know, flowery. Thank you.
that.
Enough to for people to believe we saw two little lambs curled up together. I'm saying the camera's not doing it justice, but we got about this whole steep downhill. This is mud, probably 3 inches deep. Hey, can you do that again? I didn't get it on camera, buddy. Can you frolic again? Frolic again. That was cute. Even Clint thought that was cute. Big stretch, scratch, scratch. Hey, bub.
Oh, we got here just in time, huh?
Mm-hmm. Also, the reserves are all just postcards.
A little pub cat? This way. To me, one of the most interesting and coolest parts of the Cotswold Way has been oftentimes you have to trek through people's farmland and private property. And because of that, the farm life is very rarely separated by a fence. Okay. Lizzie, do you want a lamb? I can snag you one here. I don't want the smoke.
Thank you.
We spent most of our day on day two of the Cotswold Way, exercising our right to roam. I'd say 90% of today has been spent hopping over farmers' fences, opening their gates, walking past their sheep, and trekking through their land, which is okay here in England, as the trespassing laws are much different. Wave to the cam.
The Abbey here was built in 1296. The monks living here were mostly killed. Footbridge.
Oh. The biggest mistakes we've made have been a couple yards at most.
Oh, yeah.
Looks like they just rebuilt this. Muddy when wet. Oh shit. Walking through the streets of Winchcombe right now, about 8 miles into day two. Leaving the town of Winchcombe, you can see it in the distance. We are on the fringes in somebody's sheep meadow, listening to the sheep probably talk shit about us. Pretty country. What are we, about 10 miles in?
Ford F-150.
It's called a Limited. It's not boxy enough to be a Ford. F-150, it's not. It's called a Limited. It's a Ford Limited.
Straight up, what the fuck?
Don't give him any benefits, AARP. He's climbing over walls. There's a dog and person coming up. Come here, troll. What the fuck? Is he an idiot? Huh? Is he an idiot?
Yeah.
Compacted shell pack, and then look how we're going down the woods. And see, that's the downhill. And then we're to postlip.
Respite. I see the town. Hello, horses. A little past 12 miles on what was supposed to be a 13-mile hike, but it looks like it is slowly forming into a 14. I see a town in the distance, but Sir Clinton is telling me that's not our town. They're far and few between it. Oh, dude, that's where we just came from.
No. You think that with that church there?
Yeah.
Maybe. I'll have to take a look at the map, but it could be like we went up around and then all the way around like this. Yeah.
Stay tuned, lower viewers. We might have fucked up. Continuing the theme on Cotswold Way of extreme trust, here we are cutting through someone's land with nothing in between us and their horses. And he's going to meet him around. The house right there. That was the house we just came from with the horses. Get it, boy? Get it, son? Hey, buddy. Oh, yeah, pee on that. That's yours, not mine. Yeah, right here. Hey, bud. You herding us out of here? Thank you. Cotswold Way. It's a little windy for golf, eh? The rain. Yeah. Wow. One of the landmarks on the map, the ring. More trespassing on the Cotswold Way. Or American would call trespassing. We've walked through farms and fields and herds of sheep and horses and even a cattle farm. And now we're walking through a golf course. America would never. The trail markings the past 3 miles have not been wonderful here on the Cotswold Trail. We got lost in an open field, which is easier than it sounds, I assure you. But I think we might have found our way. Oh, hey, nice to see you. Where you been? After about 16 miles, we are reaching our stopping point for the day at the Rising Sun Inn. And I forget the name, some bumfuck town in England. Day 2, complete. Praise be. Start of day 3. We begin with a steep incline just to even get to the Cotswold Way. And we will continue along that for 16 miles to Bird Flip. Is it Bird? Bird Lip? Bird Lip. It's Bird Lip. What is fly tipping?
Maybe catching fly?
Our daily treks are made longer most days because the old man litters stuff along the way, dropping his... dropping his gloves, his hat. Day 3 of the Cotswold. We just hit 5.5 miles, which means we got about 10.5 left to go, well, 11 and, well, 10 and a half. It's 16 miles. So we're not even halfway there. But we started our walk at 8. It is 10:15. So 2 hours, 15 minutes, 5.5 miles. It's pretty good to me.
They've laid bricks here because it's a straight line and it's like a road edge.
Yeah.
Here's a switchback.
Taking a piss. Cheltenham in the distance, which our walk today mostly has circled, coming from that way and in the far distance that way. False horizon.
Oh
wow! Ever have in rubble success or?
No, he wasn't. We're part of a team who some of the dogs did that. He was a scent Pacific training dog. It's, you know, like police tracking dogs.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right.
It's similar kind of principle, but he would follow your scent,
right?
Not your pathway.
Well, enjoy the rest of your day. Yeah,
nice meeting you, sir. Thank you. Kind of feel like Timothy Treadwell talking to myself in the camera on this hike. Except there are no bears out here to eat me. Just shy of 11 miles. About 4 hours and 45 minutes into the hike on day 3 here. We have in the distance our first threat of what could be rain. Starting to feel the first few drops of rain, very, very small drops. But the, you know, first rain on the trip so far. And the cloud coverage doesn't look, it's not too nightmarish, but It's enough.
Would it be so bad to be one hit wonder?
No. Depending on the song, I mean, you correct me if I'm wrong because you listened to the episode I didn't, but depending on the song and how you market it and the hit, I mean, you could live off that the rest of your life. We're currently finding shelter from the rain in a asylum for the disabled that happens to be along the Cotswold Way. Interesting. Our pace quickens about 2 miles out from Bird's Lip here on Crickley Hill. Our luck was bound to run out eventually, at least once in these 7 days. So here on day 3, we're
hiking through our first bout of real rain, and hopefully that's the last of it.
Don't forget the gale force winds.
They're pretty strong.
Although it looks like I'm in a rustic, cozy cottage in the countryside, we're not.
It's not necessarily a wilderness experience.
In my least favorite part of the Cotswold Way so far. Heavy over the garden wall vibes. Well, we ended up walking a mile and a half past our inn for the night. So we are turning back and walking back uphill to the Royal George Inn. So adding a few more steps to our trek today. I blame the rain. After the longest day so far, we are entering, finally, the town of Birdslip. Praise be. There she is, the Royal George. Departing the Royal George as we begin day four, which is supposed to be just 16 miles, but based on the last 2 days, I'm expecting 20. It's a little cold, so we've got our do-rag on, and we're ready to go. And due to yesterday's mistake, we're already familiar with the first mile and a half of this trail, so.
And it's a lovely walk through the woods.
Weather's looking good for now, so hoping that remains.
Shit.
Yeah, sorry. Our landmark.
Hydrate, babe. Run.
We were walking into Cooper's Hill Farm, a small cottage town, which is most famous for being home to the cheese rolling hill, which is coming up just along the bend here. That is alarmingly steep. The camera does not really do it justice how steep this hill is. But this is the cheese hill, the cheese rolling hill. How many ACLs and ankles has this thing ate?
I'm standing at the base of Cooper's Hill, where each May is an annual cheese rolling event, where contestants chase after a wheel of Gloucester cheddar for nothing other than the glory of catching the cheese. The event was canceled in 2010 because too many international visitors and such were coming to participate. But despite the lack of official sanctions, the race has continued among the locals ever since. No word exactly on how many broken necks or torn ACLs have occurred over the years, but it's a good thing that there's national health insurance in England.
Cheese rolling hill. I'd pass. If you need any more perspective on how steep the Cheese Hill really is, well, this shows it pretty damn well. I mean, it is a cliff.
Standing at the top of Cooper's Hill, the start line for the annual cheese roll, Chase, one question comes to mind, and I think it's gonna haunt me for a long time. Guy who said, hey, you know what could be fun? And how many beers had he had before he proposed?
Hey, yo. Once again, we're having to hike through an active golf course. We're hiking on hole 9, but we are on the Cotswold Way. We're not making a shortcut ourselves. This is the path. And we're not going around the hole. We're walking through it. It's like our responsibility not to get hit. That's crazy to me. Chap over there missed his putt. Entering the town of Painswick, which is considered the middle point, the halfway point of the Cotswold Way. Walking through lovely Painswick. Very cute town of Painswick. Probably my favorite little city we have walked through so far on the Cotswolds Way. It's everything you would imagine a tiny English town. It took me a while to find the post office. I was looking for a postcard. They didn't have any. They didn't even sell them. And the post office was just a guy sitting at a fold-out table inside of an elderly community center. So he's just surrounded by old ladies having tea and crumpets.
Something of a surprise for those.
Thanks, Grace. After 3.5 days on the trail, we have reached the halfway marker, just on the fringes of Painswick. We got 55 more miles to the end. Just came from the town of Painswick, which you can see the church steeple there in the distance.
That doesn't look good.
Not really sure what's going on, but we just entered a nature preserve and there are small little fires. But hey, good luck. It's raining and Dad just took off his raincoat. Looking at it now though, from a better angle here, I see two people and it looks like a controlled burn of brush. Doesn't he look like he converted to Islam in prison? Don't really love being greeted with this coming out of the woods. Creepy as shit.
Quarter of a mile.
Severn River. Oh, wow.
Telephone poles parallel with path.
Entering the final mile of our hike here on day four. The first day in 2 days, we did not get lost. It's very true, we're not there yet. Uh-oh, Dad. Looks like we're in a dodgy area. At the day four finish line, our B&B for the night. This morning, as we were packing up to leave our bed and breakfast in King Stanley, who the hosts of were kind enough to let us do laundry there, which we haven't done in about a week and a half, so it was good hitting the trail with clean clothes. Anyway, my dad realized he couldn't find his windbreaker. We looked everywhere in the room, it wasn't there. And we were like, how could you have lost a windbreaker? Well, then it came to me, it might have slipped off his backpack when he took it off when we entered town. But that was over 12 hours ago, and we're like, there's no way we'll be able to find it now or even pinpoint where we lost it. Well, I backtracked our steps this morning. Windbreaker secured, baby. Woo! I was given a quest, a difficult one, and I accepted it. And I was rewarded for my efforts. Hell yeah. Walking out of King Stanley as we embark on day five of our Cotswold Way trip. Today we take this all the way to, what's it called?
Wooten on Edge.
Wooten on Edge, a 15 mile trek. So light work.
top one's a little wobbly.
So much of the Cotswold Way is this. Just walking straight up a steep hill.
How about a fucking switchback?
There it is. Just now coming into sight on camera. Kind of lost him there. There it is. It's a bird, it's a plane. It actually is a little plane. It is a glider. So they don't have engines, huh? Risking it all. Almost at the top of Cam's Peak. They make you earn the views here in Cotswold, that is for sure. I will admit, it can be a bit discouraging when you pass road signs that show you the mileage to the town you are hiking to by car is 2 miles. Knowing that I have to walk uphill mostly, maybe 12 or 13 miles to that same town. And then I ask myself, why does Rice play Texas? Because it is hard. I've been tricked before in the Cotswolds, but I believe we are at the top. Walking right into it, and she's doing everything she can to meet us in the middle. Got the poncho here for quick access. Rain missed us just barely, but I don't want to jinx myself, so I'll stop talking shit. We have entered the town of Dursley, which is actually where we're staying tonight, and we'll probably be walking right past where we're staying, but because they couldn't find a twin bed set up in the town that we are walking to on the Cotswold, which is about 5 miles past Dursley. We are walking through Dursley to the next town, I'm forgetting the name. And then when we get there, then we'll call a taxi cab, come back to Dursley, stay here, and then in the morning, take a cab to where we ended our hike today. And then continue on. Woo, we doing every inch.
A 20% grade is not only unsuitable for heavy goods vehicles, it's unsuitable for me. Thank you.
Appropriately named. Once again, for I believe the third time, we have to walk through a golf course. I can't believe it. It's so weird to me. Huh. When we started our hike today on day 5, that little like tower beacon thing was way off in the distance. And out of all the signs and maps and stuff we passed, nothing could label what it was or if we were going to pass it or approach it. But it's kind of been like the Eye of Mordor all day. We keep seeing it every now and then, and it's a little bit closer. So I'm hoping, we've got about 3.5 miles left, that the trail takes us close enough that I can figure out what the hell it is. But an in on our map. Getting closer to our tower.
A homeowner along the way has set up a free water station.
Smash cut, Jardia.
Passing through the small town of North Nimbly. Not much here. Well, as we have gotten closer and closer to the Tower of Sauron, we have discovered it is called the Tyndale Monument. Don't know who or what Tyndale is.
In 1866, in memory of Sir William Tyndale, who in defiance of the authorities translated the New Testament into English. So basically, he's being oppressed by the Pope and decided to say, fuck a thou.
Why wouldn't the Pope want the Bible translated into English so more people can hear the word of God?
Because it takes the power away from the priest. It takes the power away from the church. You can't read it and apply critical reasoning to it.
It's true.
Anyway, he was burned at the stake in 1536.
Oh, good for him. What? We're not just on any street. We are on the street. We made it. Starting today, this tower was so far in the distance, it was a little speck in the distant horizon through the clouds and the fog. Now we are at its feet. Awesome. Along the Cotswold Ways, I've seen a lot of places I've wanted to just smoke a fat doobie. Wrapping up day 5 here, as in the distance we approach the city of Wooten-on-Edge. City, town, the town of Wooten-on-Edge, where we'll call a cab and have it take us back to Dursley, the town we passed 5 miles ago. And just ahead, the Star Inn will serve as today's finish line.
Don't you be gone long. Don't you be gone long. Without that number of bones.
Beginning day six, leaving the town of Wooton-on-Edge. It's quiet here. Everyone's in church. You can hear the bells in the distance. We have 15 miles today to Old Sodsbury.
Or maybe 12 and a quarter. We're not sure.
Or 20. Depends. Stopping to observe the wonders of nature's beauty. That is so gay. A little over the halfway mark on day six, and we are passing through the small town of Hawkesbury, Upton. Barely see it, but way, way in the distance, right there, is the tower we hiked to yesterday. Damn, dude. We covering ground. It's a troll's home. We are entering the village of Horton,
where everyone hears a who.
Burbaching. Walkers, please take a leaflet. These are the things they have on everybody's front of their cars. Oh. I'm good. We're wrapping up day six and walking through St. John the Baptist Church. Passing out little leaflets. And walking next to spooky graves. The tower that we walked from yesterday, right there, 14 kilometers from here. Close to the end of our walk here on day six, walking into Old Sodsbury now. We have finally reached the finish line of day six. Here, we're staying at the Sodbury House Hotel. Leaving the village of Old Sodbury, entering our final day of the Cotswold Way. Day seven, 17 miles to Bath. Some light work to finish it up. Walking across land now owned by the Dyson family. unintentionally herding some sheep right now. Down with the monarchy. Walking through another golf course on our final day. Bah. Bah. You don't care. There in the distance, we are walking past the Bath racetrack. So, getting pretty close to the end here.
We got our weatherproofs and first aid kit.
You come across much rain or not then? Because we've had low.
We're getting very close to the finish. In the distance is the town of Bath, the end of the trail. And behind me are the sheep of Bath. There in the distance, the city of Bath. And here we have the sheep of Bath. Sorry. Don't mind me, buddy. We have entered the city of Bath, but our journey is not over. The official end of the Cotswold Trail is in the center of town. And the tradition is, once you've done the entire thing, you knock on the door of the abbey in the center of town to signify you are done with the entire Cotswold. So, we should be wrapping up here very soon. Last stretch of the Cotswold Way is really, really making us earn it. We are so, so close. That steeple, that's where we're ending. It's like a football field away. Nice.
Oh, go ahead.
No, please go. Come on, hurry.
Oh, we're just gonna have to do this. Here, step where you were.
Oh.
And we'll just be separate.